creeps on the earth, and it's every bird in the air, and everything that creeps on the earth, everything has breath of life. I have given every green plant for food, and it was so. God saw everything that he had made, and indeed it was very good. And there was evening, and there was morning, the sixth day. Here ends the first lesson. The second lesson is in Romans chapter 12, verses 1 through 21. I appeal to you, therefore, brothers and sisters, by the mercies of God, to present your bodies as a living sacrifice, holy and acceptable to God, which is your spiritual worship. Do not be conformed to this world, but be transformed by the renewing of your minds, so that you may discern what is the will of God, what is good and acceptable and perfect. For by the grace given to me, I say to everyone among you, not to think of yourself more highly than you ought to think, but to think with sober judgment, each according to the measure of faith, as God has assigned. For as in one body we have many members, and not all the members have the same function, so we who are many are one body in Christ, and individually we are members one of another,
still, and the pastor weighed his options. Boy, after looking at the cry, he continued. In good times and in bad, and the bride went for it. In good times, hiccup, and in bad times, hiccup. And somebody in the front row tried to suppress a giggle but fell. And a guy about 10 rows back lost it. And he was not a giggler, but a belly laugher. And to the man's credit, he jumped out of his pew and tried to make the exit before he blew. But he never made it. Waves of laughter went back and forth across the pews of the church. The pastor laughed, the bride and groom laughed, and all the attendants likewise. The organist was hysterical. People rose out of their pews just to breathe, for they were snorting, howling, hooting, and dabbing at their eyes. And every time things started to quiet down, the bride would pick up again, and pandemonium would resume. Finally, after about 15 minutes of this, when all the laughter had been squeezed out of everybody, and the congregation looked more like survivors of a shipwreck than a wedding party, the pastor held up his hand for silence. He said that weddings were supposed to be joyful, God-blessing human events. He said that they all knew what the words were, and they knew what they meant. So in the spirit of those words, the pastor pronounced a couple, husband and wife, and blessed their marriage. In the response, the bride blurted out, "Oh, pick up, thank you." And the guy in back row lost it again, and the bride and groom raced down the aisle with laughter serving as their recessional music. Laughter, tears, joy. It's the reason we have gathered here today. Shelley and Kevin have chosen this time to stand before the altar of God to exchange their promises with each other and hear God's promise of blessing to them. We gathered here have been invited to witness this union and share in the joy of this wedding. We share the joy and the gift that life brings to us. Even Jesus himself chose to share in the joy of a wedding by his recorded presence at the wedding in Cana. He even uses the joyous occasion of a wedding to perform his first miracle. Laughter, tears, joy. God has joy in store for each of us during our lifetimes. Today we mark the joyous event of Kevin and Shelley announcing heaven to be your wedded husband, to have and to hope from this day forward, for better, for worse, for richer, for poorer, in sickness and in health, love and to cherish, of death do you part. If so, then answer, I do. Couple now exchange rings as a token of their promises made here today. Thank you. affection and understanding, courage, and love toward you, toward each other, and toward the world, that they may continue together in mutual growth according to your will, in Jesus Christ our Lord.
Amen. Let us pray for all the families of the world.
Gracious Father, you bless the family and renew your people. Enrich husbands and wives, parents and children more and more with your grace, that strengthening and supporting each other, they may serve those in need and be a sign of the fulfillment of your perfect kingdom. For with your Son, Jesus Christ, and the Holy Spirit, you live and reign one God through all ages of ages.
Amen. Let us join together in singing our Lord's Prayer.
Keep you in his life.